First of all, again, we have to make sure that everyone is playing their own responsibility. In the European Union, for example, we do put obligations on those who operate platforms to take their responsibilities, even to the extent of obliging them to obey to takedown orders where we have clearly illegal or objectionable material that is against the law or against the morals of the society in which we live. Now, that is part of a framework. We can't expect them to be the police of the internet, nor do we want them, in fact, to do that. But it does mean that we have to find a balance and give clear leadership so that we find what is best for preserving the expression of opinions, in other words, free speech, while at the same time respect for society and its cultures. And that's not an easy one to do. The European Union has done it through a series of self-regulatory and soft law approaches. But in some cases, we feel we may have to intervene, for example, with regard to terrorist content online, where clearly that material must be removed immediately. It's an ongoing process. We want to engage all of the stakeholders in it. So those who provide the services, as well as those who genuinely would have concerns about risks for free speech, so that we do continue to take account of that, the freedom of speech, which is part of the freedom of the internet.